She's off.
Gorilla moves, she's right underneath the car there.
She literally almost passed underneath the back end of the car. Can you see it?
Close.
Pete can even see it, and he's sitting right at the back edge.
Yeah, I can just see her now.
There she goes, look at that. Guys, we're going to try and get out of here as well. Obviously, she's much more agile than we are. She's heading back for the food. Try and get there at the same time as she does, which will be challenge to say the least. Alright, let's watch out for the stall on the left. That is the buffalo stall. Okay.
Point the camera away as well.
Come on. Hey! Good thing. That is the worst thorn. Of getting in and out of some of these places.
Well, that weight really paid off.
Just checking the tin up there, Pete.
Got it?
I was starting to worry that you might fall asleep. To be honest with you, I thought I might doze off. It's just so peaceful sitting there. And now, of course, she's moving again. Let's see. Yeah, she's just beautiful. I'm sitting looking at her like that. Unbelievable. Stations, gorilla as well again. Oh, there she is, look at this. Unbelievable view. Oh, balanced, poised. Look at how important the tail is in that car. Oh, just scrambled up. Amazing. You can see there. Go a bit forward. Wait, that's it. Good. Amazing, you can really see the size of the tree here as well, massive tree. Very special sight. She's going to do a bit more feeding. You can see her plucking the hair away there, cleaning the fur off the skin. So she wants to get into that rump area. That's where the most meat is. And there's still a lot of food left. I mean, we're in day two now with this carcass, and there's still, I'd say, 70%, 60% of the meat left. So maybe another 2 days if we're lucky. Three even. Probably 2 days. Still moving it a bit. I think this is more to get better access or better angle to get into that meat. Excuse me.